So yeah, as some of you sent us
to the
questions.
Welcome back to Sleep in Natty.
Record or anything?
Ha.
Hey guys, welcome back to Slick and Natty. So in today's episode, it's a little different. It's not a DIY from Ishpreet. It's a husband tag video, and a lot of you lovely people out there have sent out a bunch of questions to Ishpreet, and we are going to be talking about a lot of things about our past, how we guys met, how has been our 4-year marriage journey. So let me invite the original Slick and Natty back to ask me a few questions. She's gone to pick up a pillow so that she can be as tall as I am in the video.
Yes, I'm sitting on a cushion because he's...
I'm way taller than her.
Yeah, the height difference.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm like 10 and she's like 2.
Yeah, the height difference.
But love, as they say, is blind. Sorry, you can ask your question.
Yeah, so the height difference between us is significant. So I have to sit on a cushion. Okay, so this is a husband tag video, and on my Instagram, Facebook and Twitter accounts, I had asked you all to send in questions which I'll be asking Abhishek on your behalf about our relationship, about our life, etc., which he doesn't know about. He just has a fair idea that's going to be about a relationship and marriage, so it's all going to be spontaneous answers for him. Let's begin. Okay, so the first question is an obvious one, which is when and how did we meet?
Okay, so I guess the first time we interacted was actually on Facebook. So a lot of you don't know that Ishpreet is my junior from college.
MBA college.
From the MBA college, and I was a senior. And so there was this the help page which you know, a lot of seniors get together and they create for the incoming batch so that we can help the junior, but essentially the page was also about you know, really getting to know the incoming batch and the beautiful girls like Ishpreet who are going to be part of the batch.
So that they can scan through the profiles of the girls of the incoming batch and they can pick and choose the ones that they like.
So jokes apart, so that's where I first bumped into Ishpreet. I remember she had posted a query. I genuinely felt that she's a little concerned, and then I had messaged her on Facebook that don't worry, once you're here, everything is going to be fine. And that's how I interacted with her for the first time. That's how we got to know each other, and then I think a couple of months later she was in Bombay and
she joined the college
and again, funny story. When she joined the college, I think she expected that, you know, the first day that she's going to be here, I'm going to be waiting for her and I'll go and talk to her. But that did not happen. After a few days after she joined the college, so we randomly bumped into each other in the corridor where her classes were taking place. And yes, we interacted there for the first time. She was rushing in between two classes. She did not have a lot of time to interact, but yeah, we just had a quick hi. And after that, we went out a few times and yeah, that's how we met.
So the next question is actually related to this. Was yours love marriage or arranged marriage? Obviously, it was a love marriage.
It was, you can say technically it was a love plus arranged marriage because obviously we fell in love and then we
had to get it arranged.
Yeah, then we had to fight our way through all the complexities in life and then get it arranged.
Yeah.
So it took a lot of hard work to, you know, convince our parents. I mean, especially because we come from different religions. It's not even different caste. Then, you know, I'm Hindu, she's a Sikh, and so it did take some amount of convincing in both the families.
The next question is, what comes first to your mind when you think of each other?
Creative. I think when I think of Ishpreet, the first thing is creative. And when she started YouTube, I think a year back, I mean, a lot of you know about her story and she shared a lot of things with you guys in the past, but imagine someone who has a medical background, then she's gone on to do an MBA, she worked in a corporate life, and you know, now she started doing something which is totally different from what her background is.
For me, it would be funny and humorous. So he's the one who brings that element of humor in my life and he makes me laugh.
A big element.
A big element, yeah. So I know many of you girls out there, when you are asked what are the qualities you look for in your future husband, many of you would say sense of humor, and trust me, it's very important. It's very important because life is always going to be full of ups and downs, and you got to, you know, overcome your sorrows and keep smiling and laughing. And if your partner has a good sense of humor, it's going to help you a lot.
Perhaps I have a good sense of humor, or perhaps she has a bad sense of humor that she laughs at all my PJs and all
my
jokes.
Yeah, that too.
So maybe it's a combination of both.
Okay. Describe each other in one word.
I would say creative, but if I have to say anything else, then I would say loving. I think that is the other big word that I have for her. I mean, I think I've always secretly, wanted someone in my life, a partner who loves me a lot more than probably what I can love. I mean, I know it sounds selfish, but yeah, that's always been my, you know, what I've looked out for in a partner. And I think, yeah, that's how it is between the two of us.
It's not true actually, this is what he thinks, but if I'm more loving than him, then he's probably more caring than I am. Okay, what is the craziest thing you both did together?
I think one of
the... Sorry,
go on.
So, I don't know if it's the craziest thing, but when we were in college, we used to crash weddings a lot.
Yeah.
So when you're staying in hostel, you obviously don't get to eat good food and you really crave for good food. And our college and our hostel was in Juhu area, and Juhu in Bombay is a very posh area. So there's a lot of, you know, good,
big fat Indian weddings which happen around Juhu. So I guess we are also giving good ideas to people who stay in Juhu.
Yeah.
And guys, when you do anything, you do it at your own risk. So we did crash quite a few weddings in that area during college, and it was a lot of fun. Yeah. We were a bunch of 5 or 6 boys, and Ishpreet was the only girl who would come. Yeah. She was actually a safety net for us. Nobody would really doubt, you know, a girl coming and crashing a wedding. That is, no one really expects a girl to do that.
Yeah.
So that was a fun thing that we used to do in college. We always thought that, you know, we want to do that again. After our marriage, some of you have not been able to do it, but I really want to do that sometime soon.
One thing you hate about each other?
Actually, there are quite a few things I hate about it. But one thing, I wouldn't say hate, but that really worries me is that she ends up taking a lot of pressure, about life in general or what she's doing. And she's someone who's very particular about when she's working. She's giving it her 200% in anything that she does, and a lot of times she really gets worked up things are not happening the right way. If she has to post a video, it's getting delayed, or maybe about things in general about life.
Yeah.
Bring on the list.
So if you ask me what I hate about him, I can give you a long list, but one thing that I absolutely find irritating about him, you know, when he sleeps and then he'll tell you that wake me up at so and so time, and you go and you try to get him up, he starts calling you. He won't get up. It's so difficult to wake him up.
I'm a sleep lover, and I think this has been a common complaint that my mom has had with me over the years, and now Ishpreet has this with me. I get really cranky when I have to wake up.
Exactly. Cranky is the word.
But I guess that's how it is, right? With a lot of you out there.
No. Maybe you can let us know in the comments below this video if there is somebody in your family, your father, brother, husband, boyfriend, who acts like this. Or is it something that Abhishek is, specialized in? Okay, next question has been asked by many people. It is that how do you resolve your fights and conflicts? Who is more understanding between you two? Who compromises first when conflict arises?
I think I should answer that.
Okay.
So, I think our relationship has really evolved in that sense. And 6 years back when we met for the first time, it was definitely her.
Yeah.
And definitely her, any time, any fight, she would just call me non-stop. She would just call me, and her motto in life would be just to resolve the fight. And I would be like that, I need my space, I cannot solve, I cannot talk to you at the moment. But I think in the last 1 year or maybe a couple of years for now, I think the balance is tilted on this side. It is a lot more, being matured, being the matured one in the relationship, and really taking the first step to resolve conflict and fight. And so one thing that I can really say is that I've really grown in a relationship. I was a kid way back, 6 years back, when I met Ishpreet for the first time. And I guess now she's the kid in the relationship, and I'm more sensible, and I'm the one who's resolving fights more often than her. I mean, she also does that, but I guess maybe 7 out of 10 times I'm doing it now.
Yeah. 6 out of 10
times. 6 out of 10. Okay, you can have your 1 point. Thank you.
And also, the number of fights, have decreased over the years. Yeah. The intensity of fights.
It could be because of two things. One, because you understand each other. Two, because you've given up on life.
You've given up on each other. No, it's mainly because, as you start living together, you start understanding each other better. You start understanding each other's pet peeves, each other's annoying thing. This is an interesting one. So, what what recipes you like made by me? You'll really have to think about it.
I was really happy listening to the first part of the question when she said, what recipes? I thought it's a generic question about what are the kind of cuisines and recipes that I like. Second part, made by me, is a little difficult. No, but I think, jokes apart, I think Ishpreet is a great cook. And as I said, she's damn creative. So, and when someone is creative, I think they really apply their creativity in all walks of life.
And many times things go really wrong.
Sometimes that's okay. Sometimes things don't work. I love Indian food. I particularly like paneer butter masala a lot, and then she's learned that for me, and she's been experimenting a little bit here and there with paneer butter masala, and I really love that dish made by her. So yeah.
You don't like my rajma?
Oh, rajma. I think rajma, yes, rajma is amazing. With all the Punjabi genes that she has, rajma literally flows in their blood, and and I think like any other North Indian, I love rajma a lot. So yes, rajma and paneer butter masala it is for now.
You don't like any other thing made by me?
I would gradually. It's a long life ahead.
Not that I'm complaining, because I don't really get time to cook and learn cooking. So yeah, it's okay. And next question is, what made you support me when I wanted to leave my job and change my career altogether?
I think it was very natural for me to support her, right? I knew that, somehow the idea of going to office every day and reporting into someone was not something that, comes very naturally to her. Also, hers is a complete business family, so that's what she has seen over the years. Everybody is an entrepreneur at their place. And so I always knew that, she wanted to do something of her own, and I was always okay with that idea. One should always do what they're totally comfortable in, otherwise every day just becomes a struggle. And when she said that, she really liked the concept of YouTube and bringing her creativity in front of millions of people, so I think that was a very natural thing for her to do, and I was like, just go ahead and do it. And so that's how it is, and I think that's how she's always advised even her viewers. You guys should just pick up whatever you really like and love to do and be passionate about, and I think that's how you're going to excel.
Last question. How do you feel now that Ishpreet is a YouTube celebrity and has many followers?
It's lovely, actually. A lot of times these days we are going here and there, and randomly, one of you lovely viewers just comes up, and they talk to Ishpreet, and they say that, hey, we watch your channel and it's amazing, and it's just great. It just lights up your day. I mean, some viewer coming and appreciating your work, what you're doing. So it's amazing, I think, with all the positive attention that she's getting, a lot of people who love her. I think I couldn't have asked for anything more. Where is my coffee hamper? For answering so many questions. I thought I'm getting an hamper. No?
No. You got a lovely wife. That's your reward for life. Oh, that rhymed. You got a lovely wife. That's your reward for life. See, I told you.
Now, I guess you guys understand what we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
Being balanced.
Probably my sense of humor is so bad that I can laugh, you know, even at the
silliest of jokes
that he cracks. Yeah. So this was it, guys. This was fun for us. Hope you also liked it. And
please follow her on Instagram, YouTube,
and Facebook,
and Twitter. Oh my god.
Okay. So see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.